Hello, I'm Gypsy Metellus, and welcome to Haitian Voices. Haitian Voices is a new monthly program introducing you to diverse voices in South Florida's Haitian-American community. We'll bring you artists, writers, and entrepreneurs, as well as faith and political leaders. On today's program, we're joined by one such political leader who served his community for the better part of a decade. He is the first Haitian-American elected to the Miami-Dade County Commission and currently serves as the County Commission Chair. We welcome Commissioner Jean Monestime. Thank you so much for joining us today. So I know that the viewers have seen or heard of you, and so this is their opportunity to be introduced or fully acquainted with you today. So what do you want to tell them? How do you want to be remembered by the viewers of Haitian Voices?
Thank you, Gypsy, for the invitation. How do I want to be reminded?
Remembered.
By the viewers as a public servant, mm-hmm. as someone who came here and benefited from the good things that this country, this community has to offer, but decided to give back some of the things that I've received from this wonderful community of ours.
Mm-hmm. And so when you say you decided to give back, why don't you talk a little bit about when you got here and what compelled you to go into public service?
Well, basically, after arriving here in January 1981, I was actually in high school when I started participating in demonstrations and outreach in the community as an activist, okay? And as an activist for human rights, for better opportunities for Caribbean American individuals, especially Haitians in the days. Mm-hmm. After college, I remained an activist, and people started using my small business as a place where they can come and ask questions and ask for assistance for whatever they needed in their families, whether it's a child having problem in schools and they wanted me to talk to the child, or whether they had a letter that they needed to help, they needed help
Understanding
reading, uh-huh. what was stated in that letter. So basically, I it's in my gene to help people out.
Very good.
And later on, folks decided, well, you know what, you've been helping a lot of people. We've heard you in the street. We've heard you on the radio. People talking about what a great help you've been, and would like to encourage you to run for public office. A seat became open in the city council in North Miami, and I got recruited to run. At first, I turned that down. And
why did you turn it down?
Because I never saw myself as a politician. I didn't want to get into politics. I didn't see myself in political office. And besides, my parents didn't encourage uh-huh. Their children to serve in political office because, but after a while, I got convinced that, it's a little different. It's a different way of, providing help to people, to providing assistance to people. It's tapping into public resources to benefit one's community. So after I got educated on that a little bit, I decided, well, it's probably worth it that I tried.
Okay.
Then, surprisingly, I got elected into the city council and served there for almost 3 years and ran for mayor and lost.
So you ran for mayor of North Miami.
North Miami.
Okay.
And after I lost, I said to myself, yay, I didn't like it anyway. So
was it relief?
It was kind of like a sweet and sour mm-hmm. feeling. I didn't like it anyway. Maybe I should stay out of politics
for
good.
Why did you feel that way?
Because I felt, if I was a good politician enough, I should have won because we had the votes mm-hmm. and there were some misunderstanding in the community as to whether I should run and whether I should have
remain a council member.
Uh-huh. And I think in that case, the people that thought at the time that I should have remained a council member, they were right. And I said, well, maybe that may be a bad politician that I made the decision to run. So let me go to my niche.
Sort of running before you can walk, huh?
Yeah.
All right. So you stayed out. Once you lost that seat, you stayed out of elected office for a number of years.
Oh, for 5 years.
And so what made you decide for the county commission?
Well, I wasn't in elected office, but I was still helping in my community. And people felt, okay, why is he still helping? Maybe he wants to run again. And I never thought about running again, to tell the truth. And beside my family, my wife and my children were not supportive of me running for office ever again. Mm-hmm. And I was really not interested in running again until the same people and others who thought about me helping the community and serving the community was a good thing, decided to come back and speak to me and to my wife about running again.
Fantastic. Okay, so then you decide to run for the county commission. But before you made that decision, I know that you were a very active member of the Haitian American community.
Yes.
I remember your participation in a group called the Society of Haitian American Professionals and Entrepreneurs,
yes,
right?
And
yes. That was all about what? What did you want to achieve?
Well, this was all about community empowerment. Mm-hmm. We wanted the community to be developed politically, business-wise, economically. We wanted to have a collective understanding on how to address all our issues, including immigration issues. We wanted the community to transition from being a community of refugee to a community of immigrants. Mm-hmm. Folks who understand, how to access, the halls of power and all the resources that are available throughout our communities.
Absolutely.
And throughout the United States.
Absolutely. Yeah. So now as County Commission Chair, what do you want to achieve, either as chair, because I know that term will end soon, but mm-hmm. as a commissioner, what do you want to achieve in terms of the good that you do for this community?
I want to provide my community with greater access to government resources. I want my community to understand how to maneuver the hall of power. I want to help my community become a more prosperous community. Mm-hmm. I want people to become homeowners, business owners. I want social services to really have the opportunity to serve more individuals and help elevate them out of poverty. Mm-hmm. So that's exactly why I created the Chairman for Council for Prosperity Initiative, is to help people better themselves, and if you become a better individual, you'll be a better citizens as well.
Absolutely. So, mm-hmm. young viewers who could maybe be watching you right now, what lesson do you want them to take away from your experience?
Well, it's something that they've heard a lot in the United States of America that I'd like to repeat. In this country, there isn't really anything you can achieve once you put your mind to it, mm-hmm. but you have to prepare yourself for the opportunity. So people don't really just get lucky. You have, because the opportunity may arise, but if you're not prepared, you cannot take that opportunity. For example, I tell young people that I will never become head surgeon at Jackson or at Baptist because I'm not prepared for that. So whether I'm lucky or not, I will not get there. But for anything else that you prepare yourself for, when the opportunity shows up, you'll be able to take it.
And so your message to these young folks would be to prepare themselves?
Yes.
And be ready for
prepare
the opportunity.
Prepare yourself academically, prepare yourself emotionally, prepare yourself financially for the right opportunity.
Very good. And so I know that recently, you took it upon yourself to really make sure that people in this community would understand the situation in Haiti, the tragic situation mm-hmm. post-Hurricane Matthew. Mm-hmm. So briefly tell us how that's going.
Well, it's so far so good. But we asking folks who want to contribute to the welfare, to the redevelopment, the reconstruction of the devastated areas of Haiti, to truly contact my office and to contact Saint-La, who's my partner in this endeavor. Reasons why is because I've put together a credible group of individuals, elected officials and civic-minded leaders to really raise funds to help the municipalities that have been devastated by Hurricane Matthew
in Haiti. So for full disclosure, I serve as the executive director of Haitian Neighborhood Center, the nonprofit which is acting as fiscal agent receiving the donations for the relief efforts.
For the South Florida Haiti Relief Group.
Thank you, Commissioner. And so unfortunately, we're out of time. You see how fast time flies when you're having fun? We'll have to leave it there. And so we thank you again, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you so very much.
All right.